Hi everyone, welcome back. So today we are going to be doing Chipotle bowls for dinner, but I'm going to be doing it with barbacoa today, and this will be the second time I do barbacoa. And before we go further, I do want to mention there's many different ways people do like their barbacoa recipes. Many people use either chuck roast, they'll use brisket, or they'll use beef cheeks. Either one of those three. Here I have about almost 3 pounds. This is from Central Market. I got this yesterday and I was like, you know what, let me cook this with all of you guys. Again, this will be the second time I try this recipe. The first time I did it, I think I overcooked the meat a little too long and it was a little hard for me to shred the meat. So practice makes perfect. I'm gonna try it for the second time today. Even when I cooked the meat a little too long, Alan still really enjoyed it. Like, it had so much good flavor. But today I'm just gonna cook the chuck roast for a good 4.5 to 5 hours. That's what we're gonna be doing today. And not only are we cooking some chipotle bowls together, we are also going to the gym later. So I do need to get the beef, the chuck roast cooking, because this is what takes the longest. Okay, here is the chuck roast. This is almost 3 pounds. I got a big piece, that way we can have leftovers. Okay, so I'm now cutting the chuck roast into big chunks and we're just gonna be seasoning it with salt and pepper. Now that we seasoned it, we are going to add it to the pan, and I've already added avocado oil to the pan. And we're gonna sear the meat on both sides just for a little bit. You're not trying to fully cook the meat, we're just searing the top and bottom. And then once that's done, we're gonna add it into the crock pot. Once the meat is added into the crock pot, we're then gonna start making the sauce. I'm using chicken broth, but you can use beef broth or you can even use water. Now that we have the sauce ready and nicely blended, we're gonna add it into the crock pot, and then we're gonna add some more of that broth, just enough to cover up the meat. The last ingredient we're gonna be adding into the crock pot is 3 bay leaves, and I'm gonna leave this cooking for 3 to 3.5 hours on high.
The house is starting to smell so good. The meat has been cooking for a good 2.5 hours and it still needs some more time in there. So meanwhile, we're gonna go ahead and start making the salsa. Now, if you're a fan of Chipotle's red salsa, I'm gonna do a similar one. I don't know exactly what ingredients Chipotle uses, but I'm gonna be making one that tastes really good and you only need 3 ingredients. We're gonna be using 3 tomatillos. I have 3 large ones right here. And then we're also gonna need chile de árbol. This is how they look if you've never purchased these before, but definitely get them because it really does make your salsa a difference. So yeah, chile de árbol, tomatillos, and salt. You can add garlic if you wanna add garlic or onion, but I'm just gonna use 3 simple ingredients. Let's get the rice ready. Meanwhile, the tomatillos get soft in the boiling water. This is the rice I always use. I'm gonna cook 2 cups of rice because I want leftovers for tomorrow as well. Rice is cooking, so once the rice is done cooking, that's when we add the rest of the ingredients to make that cilantro, citrusy, delicious rice Chipotle does. The meat is almost done and it smells amazing.
Okay, so now that the tomatillos are soft, we are gonna be adding that to the cup, and look how toasty these chilies are. You don't wanna overcook them, just want them nicely grilled. We're gonna blend it together and it just comes out so, so good. Give it a try if you've never had this salsa, but it's perfect for tacos as well, so good.
Okay, I don't know about you, but I really like to add some veggies into my chipotle bowl. So I'm gonna put some bell pepper and onion to grill, and then we're also gonna be adding some seasonings. Thank you. been done since a long time ago. Just kind of mixing it a little bit before I add the other ingredients. Adding lemon and adding lime, salt. Rice is done. That was so easy. Now I'm just gonna leave it covered. That way it stays nice and warm.
Okay, Alan's on the phone, so in case you hear someone, that's him. But I'm gonna quickly show you. The rice came out perfect. It's still really warm. And then I have my pinto beans. These have low sodium. I always get the ones that have low sodium. You can either use pinto beans, black beans, whatever you like. And then we have our delicious tender meat. It came out way better than last time. It tasted good last time, but it was just not as tender as this time. And I'm super excited to eat already. Here we have our sides. Pico de gallo is a must in my Chipotle bowl. I added a serrano instead of a jalapeno, and it has that perfect kick. But if you don't want it too spicy, just use a jalapeno instead. Veggies, of course, and then the corn. The salsa, so good. Alan loves this one. Our sour cream. Okay, this is a cool trick if you didn't know, but I use light sour cream. And you know how sour cream is thick, but if you want that watery consistency like this, then add whatever milk you have in your fridge. And then I am using light mixed cheese. Chipotle uses Monterey Jack, I believe. And then we have our lettuce and our wok. Wok is just super simple. I didn't show you guys, but I just smashed a whole large avocado, added salt, a bit of lime juice, and then a bit of red onion. And now let's go ahead and serve because I am hungry.
Okay, it is the next day. Yesterday, I was supposed to go to the gym later at night after we had dinner, about a few hours later. But we didn't end up going. One, we were still really full because we devoured our delicious barbacoa chipotle bowls. They were so good. So I missed yesterday's workout, which is totally fine. I wasn't like mad about it, just because usually I go to the gym 5 to 6 times out of the week. And yesterday was the first day that I missed the workout, and I still have all the other days to work out. So yesterday's workout I'm gonna do today, and I'm doing upper body, and I'm also doing some cardio. And then tomorrow is another lower body day. Lower body days are my absolute favorite. I'm starting to like upper body days more than I used to, for sure, because I never wanted to work out my upper body before, but now I'm starting to like it. I love doing back workouts. I hope you guys enjoyed that delicious Chipotle bowl that I showed you yesterday. It was so good. I'm so happy that the meat came out 10 times better than last time. I feel like I have it down already. With that being said, let's go ahead and head to the gym, work out, and hopefully the gym isn't packed. That way I'm able to show you like my workout. Sometimes like if there's people there, I don't like to place my camera where I'm showing people, because I don't want them to feel uncomfortable in any way. So hopefully we have the gym to ourselves. We'll see. Also, I don't know if you noticed, but yesterday I had on my press-ons, and I ended up taking them off last night because I had them on for a week and a half, which I was surprised. They stayed on for a really long time, but one flipped off yesterday when I was washing dishes, trying to enjoy my natural nails for a little bit. really good workout. I did the 20 minute rock climb with Kendall Poole. That class was intense. I want to say I did it once before. There's a lot of classes of hers that I repeat. Like, I do them over and over again because they're just my favorite. Workout, I did about 5 to 6 workouts, and I already know my back's going to feel sore tomorrow because I can feel it. I do all my workouts slow and controlled. You guys know that. I show you that all the time on my... Every single time I work out, I always mention to do them slow and controlled. That way you do the workout correctly, you don't injure yourself, and you really do feel the workout a lot more. But yeah, that was my upper body and the cardio I did today. And I am gonna do a video showing you all the workouts I do throughout the week, because I know a lot of you have asked for that. Currently cleaning my phone. I always clean my phone with Clorox wipes as soon as I get home. But yeah, you guys, that is it. I'm gonna quickly make myself a protein shake. If you wanna know exactly which one I'm going to make, I'll put the video up here, the link, and click that video and you will see exactly which protein shake I drink and what I put in it and all of that. But I'm gonna have that right now. Hope you subscribe, that way you can see my future videos. And if you're already subscribed, thank you so much, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.